Hey, this is Ben Brown, WWE's archivist, and we're here to take a look at championship titles from 60 years of WWE history. Let's have a look. This is the original WWE Championship, 1963. So you'll find it a little odd that a world championship has a nameplate that's shaped like the United States of America. Prior to this being the first WWE Championship, which was held by Buddy Rogers, this was a United States Championship in a number of different territories. WWE came to be when Lou Thesz regained the NWA Championship from Buddy Rogers. Vince Sr. didn't want to promote Lou Thesz as his champion anymore, mostly because Lou Thesz was not going to make the required number of stops in the New York territory. So Buddy Rogers was asked, hey, do you happen to have a championship title? And this is what he had. So we brought this in as the first ever WWE championship. You'll see right in the middle here, there's a little slot for somebody's photo. Had a chance to show this to Bruno, who won this championship off of Buddy Rogers several years ago. And Bruno was kind of blown away, you know, just to hold this thing in his hands and be like, this is exactly how I remember it. And this is the start of a huge journey. And it really was just who's got a title belt. And Buddy Rogers had one, and here it is. All right, so now that we've had a chance to look at the first ever WWE Championship, let's take a look at the subsequent WWE Championships. Bruno Sammartino, an untouchable record. This is the most representative version of Bruno Sammartino's WWE Championship. You've got the two championship title holders on here. You got Buddy Rogers and Bruno Sammartino, because at that point, those were the only two people that had ever won the WWE Championship. I don't think there was ever an intention to keep that Buddy Rogers United States Championship as the WWE Championship. It was only a matter of time before they created a custom WWE Championship and to be held by really the greatest WWE Champion of all time, and I'd argue that through and through, Bruno Sammartino. What we're looking at here is the WWE Championship from really 1970s through the early 1980s. You actually had a few transitional championships in between the one that we just looked at and this one. Those were held by Pedro Morales, but Pedro also held this. So did Superstar Billy Graham. So did Bruno Sammartino again. So did Bob Backlund. So did Stan Stasiak. Look at this beautiful raised eagle on here. So you know you have different places where it might have been defended. This one's really cool. So again, this is another real replica, as it were. It is made in the same vein as the real deal. That one specifically was bashed by Superstar Billy Graham in front of Bob Backlund, and just kind of in pieces, and led to the next championship being introduced. But if you were a fan in the 1970s of the second longest reigning WWE champion of all time, that's Bob Backlund, you think of this title. So moving on, Big Green was first held by Bob Backlund, was then held by Iron Sheik, Hulk Hogan, and then we're off to the races. So this is Hulk Hogan's first ever championship. Having the past champions listed on the title, I think this was to really give that significance of like how big of a deal this championship was, right? And kind of gigantic too, right? This was the championship that, you know, really ushered in Hulkamania. There's an iconic picture of Hulk Hogan backstage, and I think he's got champagne poured on him, and it's the start of the big boom in the 1980s and Hulkamania and WWE going worldwide. Moving on from the Big Green, we had a couple of other titles that Hulk Hogan only wore. But after those, the Winged Eagle is about as well known as any of them. This guy started with Hulk Hogan. Actually, on Hogan's, you had here on one of these side plates, it would have said Hulk Hogan underneath on the actual one that Hulk Hogan wore. This one wasn't held by Hulk Hogan, but it is a ring-used championship held by Randy Savage, Shawn Michaels, Andre threw this thing over his shoulder, Bret Hart, Yokozuna, among others. I can tell you why specifically this was held by Bret Hart and Yokozuna. There's a little detail right here. See, a little piece of the wing is broken. There's a shot of Yokozuna holding this over his shoulder, and you can see the little piece of the tip of the wing broken. Same with Bret Hart. A lot of people love this little detail here, this bar kind of floating to the outside. I also love, you know, the detail of the plate at the end of the strap, just kind of a nice nice little extra detail. This style of championship is also held by people like the Ultimate Warrior, who put different colored straps on it. You know, there was a purple strap, like blue strap. It was also in No Holds Barred the movie. This was prized by many, and one of my favorites. So this is the Attitude Era Championship, kind of a plussed up version of the Winged Eagle. Here introduces the Lions. You get to see a little more of the world, which is pretty cool. Anybody know what this is? That is the McMahon family crest in the WWE Championship. I weirdly think of Kane when I think of this title, though I know it's held by The Rock and by Triple H and Mankind and by Vince McMahon himself. I believe actually when this debuted, the leather was a blue color, like a really dark blue color. This was presented by Vince McMahon during the big rivalry between Vince McMahon and Stone Cold Steve Austin. This is quintessential Attitude Era with some appearances by the Smoking Skull WWE Championship as well. The Undisputed Championship. This came about the Big Eagle Attitude Era Championship and the WCW World Heavyweight Championship at the time were being kind of held simultaneously. Then they came together into one championship presented to Triple H. Gosh, this thing was held by, you know, Eddie Guerrero and Hulk Hogan, Brock Lesnar, Undertaker. Kind of interesting about this one, the McMahon family crest, full on two sides there. Here's your eagle, right? The prestigious eagle that everybody seems to love. So it's still holding on. It's not as big of a part of this championship as the other titles. You got these stars. The average WWE championship is right around 12, 13 pounds. I think this one clocks in at like 17. The final holder of it was the person who changed it from the Undisputed to the Spinner Championship. So this was won by John Cena off of JBL at WrestleMania 21. And then, you know, subsequently we moved on to the Spinner title. Some people's favorite and some people's least favorite. This thing went through different machinations over time. It said SmackDown on the side at one time. It said Monday Night Raw on one side at a time. This one just basically says, you know, WWE champion. John Cena introduced this title. It spun, and at a certain point, they stopped it from spinning. This was 2005 to 2013. That's a huge amount of time for something that was started as a John Cena specific title. You know, Rey Mysterio held this title. Triple H wore the spinner. There's no world heavyweight or world wrestling. It's the WWE champ. Very blinged out. It's very hip hop 2000. There were times where this championship was modified to specific talent. You know, very famously, the rated R superstar Edge put a big R right in the middle as opposed to WWE. We think of that as being a whole new title, but it was something applied on the top of the championship. It wasn't they went out and created a whole new R, you know, for that title. It was actually done pretty quickly. The Miz, when he won this championship, literally just took what was the W, turned it upside down and says, this is the Miz title. It was able to be modified to fit specific superstars, and part of its longevity was just that. This is the scratch logo version of really what I call just the WWE Championship. You'll see here the side plates. It was debuted with two big Brahma bulls on the side by The Rock, can be removed, and whoever is champion at the time, their title design on the side. You know, big WWE logo right in the middle, big champions, and you know, you have all these Swarovski crystals and the bars in between right here for flexibility. The original, it was quite heavy. We implemented a new vendor and a new technology to essentially route out the back of the plates. So you cast the plates and then you dig out a lot of the aluminum behind the plates to kind of make these a little more hollow and a little bit less hefty. Still super durable. This is unmistakably the WWE Championship. This style of having the WWE being that center plate and being the majority of the center plate, I think is a home run. This is the current WWE Championship. Big logo. Look what it says at the bottom. World Heavyweight Champion. Obviously, it's very small. The other one just said WWE Champion, but John Cena very famously wore both championships around his neck. But after Brock Lesnar beat John Cena, they debuted this new championship with the new logo and brought us into this new era of WWE. Really not a lot else different about it other than the logo and the champion at the bottom, but here we are in the current era, this shares a design very similar with the Universal Championship, which is on a blue leather, which was once on a red leather. We're living in Roman Reigns' era where he's holding both titles, and we'll see what comes next. Thanks for taking a look at 60 years of WWE Championships. And here's to more for the grandest prize in all of sports entertainment.